say you want a revolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world.
So I'm Gary, the mayor of Strawberry Fields, to Barack Obama. Officially, as of right now, I'm running for president of the United States.
Considered a very beautiful building architecturally, it was built in 1884. It's called the Dakota Apartments. It's had its most famous resident was actually John Lennon, who was killed right there in front of it where those black gates are. John Lennon was shot there on December 8th, 1980, John's memory. It's called Strawberry Field.
How you doing, folks? I'm Gary. I'm the mayor of Strawberry Fields. Welcome to New York, folks, and welcome to the jungle. Now, I'm going to tell you about John Lennon and Strawberry Fields.
Let me take you down, because I'm going to Strawberry Fields. Nothing is real, and nothing to get hung about. Strawberry Fields. Living is easy with eyes closed. Misunderstanding all you see. It's getting hard to be someone, but it all works out. It doesn't matter much to me. Let me take you down, 'cause I'm going to Strawberry Fields. Nothing is real, and nothing to get hung about. Strawberry Fields forever.
It took two Italian craftsmen from Naples, Italy, 10 days to do the mosaic, piece by piece. There's about 10,000 pieces in there. The design is also the design from the ruins of Pompeii. Now the road outside and the road inside in here is in shape of a teardrop. Now across the street, right there on the corner, that's the Dakota. But in the middle of the building where the archway is, the two gas lamps, the plant light, and the golden booth, that's the main entrance. Inside, left side, unfortunately, where he was assassinated. I give you peace signs, whether they're one, two, or three. Today happens to be two, with a wave in the front and a wave in the back. The yellow, the red little roses going around the Imagine symbolizes Here Comes the Sun for George Harrison.
Well, it's called Strawberry Jam, folks. On April 14th, I made the New York Post, and the only thing here was, like my uncle said, only weird but true would be next to you. Okay, so it's really funny about that part. Because they said I was supposed to be on the front page, or I was supposed to be on page 4 or 5. And when you're on page front page, you get page 4 or 5 in New York. But I got beat out by Ortiz and the Yankees with his jersey and into the stadium. And then I got beat out by Marilyn Monroe giving a blowjob to JFK. Ooh. So I wind up on page 21, and 21 is good luck. It's all going to work. The New York City cops try to stop me from doing what I'm doing. But I've been doing this for 15 years, off and on, steady every day for 7. What am I doing wrong? Nothing. I'm doing a damn thing. I'm giving you the love and the peace for John. What he wanted the world to be out of. Basic, easy, simple, peace. Flower power didn't work. Start again. What's so hard, folks? So I'm doing it. You got to want the peace. I'm not worried about cops. I'm not worried about the government. Okay? Because you do kill me, I know where I'm going. I'm going straight upstairs.
God wants me here. I'm going to keep doing what I do for the brother, for everybody in this world. It's for you. It's not for me. I have what I want for me. I have the man upstairs. He takes care of me. When he wants me, I go to the pearly gates and I go play in the gardens upstairs. Until he calls me, this is my garden. Remember one thing, folks. John always said one thing. Flower power didn't work. Start again. So I am. I'm going to give you your peace through John. And it's all through John. Now you people need to understand and wake up for the peace. I'll tell the government where to go. I'm not worried. What are you going to do? Kill me? You kill me, the world knows you shot John Lennon. Peace and love. Listen to me and listen to me carefully, all right? It's very easy. The movies have given you the previews of the world today, but everybody's too blind to see it. So this is how it goes. The Jetsons, the cartoon, that's your future. Well, let's throw Star Trek in there too. Beam me up, Scotty. Here's your cell phone. Okay, now Escape from New York, it happened already. The World Trade Center going down. You couldn't get on or off this island. Now there's a movie called The Day After Tomorrow. Like California is supposed to go goodbye. There's an island off of Africa. I believe it's Madagascar. And it should have happened already, okay? So there will be a tsunami when it does happen between Washington, D.C. and Boston. You cannot get rid of, you cannot evacuate New York City in 12 to 13 hours. It's impossible. So here's the ending, folks, which is part of your life. You know the movie, you know the actor Kevin Costner? Well, you know the movie The Postman, if you've seen it? Need I say any more, folks? Wake up before it's too late. I love you. Come with me. Fight the government. Listen, fight the government. Obama, I bring everybody home. Not Iraq, everybody. This is one nation. One nation, okay? With 50 states. One nation, one state for everybody. The same law for everybody. How you doing, folks? I want to do one thing what John wanted to do. 3-day concert, Republican Convention Party. All right? Bob Dylan, brother, you're still alive. Come and talk to me. Let's get this party rolling. Bono, I need you too. Let's go. Aerosmith, Tyler, remember, I had the key, remember? Okay, let's go with everything. Everybody that's straight. Eric Clapton, Greg Allman, all you brothers. Now it's time to talk. Come, please. Peace.
Say